Before we really talk about the game against Southern, I know you have had a really good relationship with Carl, really ever since you've been here. And not just with Carl, but I know all the alumni who will also be coming back tomorrow. Just what will it mean for you for that curtain to drop and to be able to walk in here every day and practice and know that the number 22 Carl Nix will be up there with Larry Bird and Dwayne Clee, two guys I know who you respect very immensely?
Yeah, first and foremost, he's a terrific man. He has been so good to me, I can't even tell you. He's, other than Brad Miley and Bob Heaton in town, when I got to meet Carl, there were some hurt feelings and some things that had happened here in the past. Has nothing to do with the program now, has nothing to do with administration now. We had to heal some wounds, and we've certainly done that. And as it showed in the 79-year reunion, how special that was for everybody, including the team. And Carl is just he's a wonderful person. He's got a great perspective on basketball and your players. And believe me, those guys are always watching. Those guys are always watching. And I just can't thank him enough for how good he's been to me as a person, the support, unconditional support. And to get that jersey put up there, it's long overdue, like Coach Clee said, long overdue, but it's very, very deserving and awfully cool to be up there next to his teammate.
When you think of how he played, you know, I know a lot of your guys probably, well, one, they weren't even born, let alone when that year was going on. But what can they take away from maybe some of the highlight footage from watching him play that they can really embody what Carl was about?
Well, you just really play hard. You know, you try to talk about that's the minimum. They call Carl Mr. Intensity, and that's what goes a long way to getting his number retired. But the stats he put up defensively because of what he did, I just showed the guys a couple minutes of highlights of Carl guarding first-team All-American Sidney Moncrief and just doing those types of things. But Carl was a tremendous player, great player, but he always played really hard.
Felt like Valpo, your group played hard, and you've talked about it. Probably been asked every question about, you know, trying to get the guys to play hard, but it really has seemed like in the past couple days in practice you've been able to build off of that.
Yeah, you know, and it doesn't look like, you know, and when in our tough times, it doesn't look like the body language isn't good. It doesn't look like they're playing hard, but there's a lot of mental in basketball, and we've had to use some things off the court and trying to help our guys there. They're a good group of guys, but we're just too quiet. And we're not near where we need to be as far as with our communication, but it's getting better. I felt a little flip in how we prepared and how we went about it with our communication and in the huddles throughout the game. I'm hoping it continues.
Is the huddle stuff in terms of, talked about with Coop, how good he was in the huddle, JB, even though he fouled out, he was still obviously into the game. Is that stuff you really can't coach, and knowing you can't really coach it, knowing that you saw it and it was really your guys who brought it up, as a good sign?
Well, you can't completely change somebody. You can't make somebody that doesn't say too much like your best talker. But Jordan Barnes has gotten better, you know, every year, and he was tremendous even after he fouled out. And I just try to tell him that's what you have to do when the tough times are going during games. Tyreek is getting better at it. Cooper's really added something special, and Bronson's as good a talker as we have out on the floor. So talk to these guys about the NBA type stuff. You know, I've been to a lot of practices and a lot of games. The way they communicate on the court is eerie. How much those guys talk, and they do it at the highest level, and it makes a big difference. So it's our biggest liability. So you either keep doing it and getting your butt beat, or you start changing and get out of your comfort zone, and maybe some better things will happen.
Tyreek's development, you know, him even before he got here. I remember when he first got here in the summer, got to the fall. You talked about how, man, his body transformed in just those short 3 or 4 months. Now over a year of playing, being through this year. When you watch him play and you see him now be able to drive to get fouls, to get to the foul line, to be able to knock down the outside shot, what has impressed you most being able to watch and coach Tyreek and how he's been able to take criticism, to be able to talk a little bit more, but to develop where now he is a guy that can go off for 30-plus points and be your leader?
Yeah, for being a guy in high school that you just had the ball in your hands and you got baskets. That's what you did nonstop. You know, it wasn't necessarily a thinking game or both ends of the floor, any of that stuff. So there's so much new, even though he had a great high school coach, there's so much newness with Tyreek. And now he's, you know, the film study and hearing the coaches and say, here's how people are playing you and here's what you need to do. But you give him all the credit because he puts in the work. So when he's open, he's going to make it. If not, he can drive it in there, and he can score it. And he's only going to get better. I mean, he is only going to get better, and so fun to watch him play.
Southern coming in tomorrow, just talking about the game. I know the first time around is one you kind of want to flush out, specifically in the second half of that game against Southern. But most of the time offensively that game, you really liked what you did because you were able to score. Just again, kind of that theme. I'm sure the defensive effort has been the biggest focus the past couple of days.
Yeah, I think we had them and can't remember, it was Illinois State back to back, and we just let both of those teams get really comfortable. And you can't do that. Nobody lets us get comfortable, and you got to make things tough on them. You got to try to take things away. We had no answer for Fletcher. He torched us, and he was a player of the week that week. But they got so many good inside out. They got tough guys. They got good shooters. Cook is super with the ball in his hands, and really, really fast and athletic. So. And it's no wonder they're picked in the top three in the league. I mean, they're a really good basketball team with a great head coach. So we're going to have to play awfully well and hopefully play as hard as Mr. Intensity used to.